Hello friends, today we are going to discuss here the topic number first of our subject, Sacral Practice, Introduction to Corporate Finance. As all of you know, there is change in syllabus from this academic year for 12th standard. So as per change, there are 12 topics. There are 12 topics. That is the syllabus of Sacral Practice. The first topic is Introduction to Corporate Finance. Second topic is Sources of Corporate Finance. Third is Issue of Shares. Fourth is Issue of Debentures. Fifth is Deposits. Sixth is Correspondence with members. Seventh is correspondence with debenture holders. Eighth is correspondence with depositors. Ninth is depository system. Tenth is dividend and interest. 11th is financial market. And 12th is stock exchange. The marking distribution system for this subject is 80-20 pattern. It is 80 marks theoretical paper and 20 marks internal assessment test, that is objective test, which is conducted by school at school level. As you conducted your examination for 11th commerce. So before starting this topic, just we make a quick revision of what we studied in 11th commerce. The first topic is secretary. In this topic, we discuss about what is meant by secretary, types of secretary, importance, features, definitions. Next, joint stock company, types of companies, various forms of business organization, documents related to the formation of joint stock company, steps in incorporation of company, key managerial personnel, meetings, company meeting first, company meeting second, and correspondence with different authorities. So in this here we also studied 12 topics. So from today we start our first topic, it is Introduction to Corporate Finance. In this topic we study meaning of corporate finance, importance of corporate finance, capital requirements, fixed capital, working capital, capital structure, their definition and components, and distinctions. So the first part, introduction. The term finance is derived from Latin word. The term finance is derived from a Latin word finis, which means end, and the word corporate is derived from Latin word corpus. So both the term corporate and finance is originally derived from their Latin word. So first part is introduction of topic. The term finance is related with the money and management of money. The term finance is related with the money, management of money. Okay, how the money is managed, how the company use money, how company utilize money, how company raise funds or capital or money through various sources. As for one of the statement of Henry Ford, money is an arm or leg. We use it or we lose it. This statement is enough sufficient to give or state the importance of the concept of finance in the business. Okay, before starting a corporate meaning of corporate finance, when we discuss in our daily life also, the term finance or the money is required for each and everything. For purchasing anything, money is helpful to satisfy our each and every basic needs. In today's competitive world, without money, we cannot survive on the earth. So, from the birth up to death, for each and every moment, we require money or finance. For that purpose, we have to make a proper arrangement of various segments, various sources. We forecast requirement of money need, for the purpose of future. After forecasting, we take unnecessary steps for raising money. So corporate finance deals with raising and using of finance by a corporation. It deals with the financing activities of the corporation, capital structure. As all of you studied in accountancy, capital means the amount of or the amount which is invested by business owner in the business known as capital, and structure means the proper arrangement of various segments of the capital or the sources of the capital in proper proportion known as structure. After raising money, one of the decision which is taken by finance manager that is related to the invest decision. After raising money, how to utilize money, how to use money efficiently to achieve a desired goal of the organization, desired goal of financial management, investment for that purpose. Investment make a crucial importance. So the next point, definition of money. Henry Hagland expresses the views that corporate finance deals primarily with the acquisition and use of capital by business corporation. Here, acquisition means accumulation, raising of money, and use of capital. After raising of money, we use a capital or use of money for business corporation. The term business corporate finance also includes financial planning in ordinary sense, or as far as our management subject is concerned, planning means deciding in advance what is to be done in future. But when we are talking about financial planning, we decide the financial need, money need for our future. Next, even financial organizations and banks play an important role in corporate financing. Financial manager or finance manager have performed certain functions for his organization related to the financial activities of his firm or business organization. He has to make the firm has adequate finance. They are using the right source of funds that have minimum cost. After raising finance, deciding sources of finance, finance manager raise finance. After raising finance, it is the duty of finance manager to take investment decisions. They are generated maximum returns to its investors. Means when finance manager invests its money, he or she invest money in such a way that the returns on the investment must be maximum. There are two bases of corporate finance: financing decisions and investment decisions. Financing decisions, there are various sources of finance, own sources and borrow sources. The firm can choose whether it wants to raise equity capital or debt capital, or raise finance to financial institutions such as banks, from banks, non-banking financial corporations, in the form of public deposits, in the form of debentures. The finance manager ensure that the firms is well capitalized. There is requirement of proper combination of debt and equity capital. Investment decision. Once the firm has gained access to capital, the finance manager has to take decision regarding the use of the funds in systematic manner so that will bring maximum returns to its investors. For this, the firm also take into consideration the concept of cost of capital. Firm must invest money in such a way that the business at the end of year, at the end of financial assessment, the result should be the earning or returns on the investment is more than the cost of capital. Cost of capital is nothing but a minimum returns expected by its investors. Minimum returns expected by its investors.